Hello everyone, let's start with exercise 1.2. So the question number 1 says, state whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. Every irrational number is a real number. So yes, it is very much true that every irrational number is a real number. Why? Because real number is a set of irrational number as well as rational number. So therefore we can say that irrational numbers belong to real number. So this is true. Second one, every point on the number line is of the form under root m, where m is a natural number. Now you know that on a number line we have numbers like positive numbers as well as negative numbers. So it could be negative, it could be positive, anyway. Now they said that m is a natural number. M is a natural number only. So natural number is, we know 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So we can't get negative numbers from the natural numbers. So therefore we can say that this is false, that every point on the number line is of the form under root m, can't be expressed on a number line. So this is for question number 2. Now third, every real number is a irrational number. So real number, we know, is a set of irrational and rational numbers. So therefore we can't say that every real number is a irrational number. It could be rational as well. So therefore we can say that this is false again. The second one is false and the third one is false and the fourth one is true. Now question number 2. It says, are the square roots of all positive integers irrational? So suppose we take 4. So 4 is 2 square under root and we get 2. So this is rational. 2 is a rational number. Now if we take 7, 7, 10, under root 3, it would all be irrational numbers. So we can't say that the square roots of all positive integers would be irrational. There could be a chance that they could be a rational, like under root 4, we have under root 16, under root 16 can be represented as 4. So therefore we can't say that it is a irrational number. They could be irrational. So that's your answer for question number 2. Now moving on to question number 3, we need to show that under root 5 can be represented on a number line. So in this, when we need to represent under root 5 or any irrational number, there is a method to perform, that is Pythagoras theorem. So I will be considering under root 5 as my hypotenuse. So this is my hypotenuse square. We know the Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square equals perpendicular square plus base square. So perpendicular, in this case, we need to take perpendicular and base such that we get under root 5 whole square on the left hand side. So now the first thing we need to take is base. So I would be taking my base as 1 unit. So 1 square is 1, and what must be here in the perpendicular? It must be 2. Why 2 square? Because 2 square is 4 plus 1 square is 5. So we can see that our left hand side and right hand side are same. So we need to take perpendicular and base such that they must be same on left hand side as well as on right hand side. Now we need to draw this on a number line. So we will be using 1 unit, that is OA, that will be my base. So this will be 1 unit. You can even take 1 inch here. Now as a perpendicular, what we need to take is 2 inch. So this is 2 inch here. Now what will be my hypotenuse? My hypotenuse will be under root 5. Now there is one more method to describe under root 5. OB is your under root 5, one thing. And other method is, you can choose your O point and from O draw an arc from B, like this, and extend A point. Now this part OC part will be your under root 5 again. So you get two values from this, that is OB as under root 5, one is hypotenuse, another is with the help of R. You need to keep your compass here at point O and draw an arc from B point till C on a number line. So your the base will be your then under root 5. So you get two values of under root 5 from these number lines. Thank you for watching exercise number 1.2. I will be uploading exercise 1.3 in the next video. Thank you for watching.